It was supposed to cheer you up, not make you cry.
I can't help it. It's just so nice. I've never been given anything this nice before. And it's just that...
Just what, Doreen? What's wrong? Well, something is.
Think what the others would do if they found out. They don't take kindly to secret meetings with police. It smells of lagging.
Does it?
Don't waste my time. Have you got anything for me or not?
I have a little something that might interest you. But B. Smith is now on kitchen duty.
So?
Well, she'll be collecting a little extra shipment in with a normal delivery. A shipment just for the women.
Shipment of what?
Extra food, goodies, does it matter? The thing is to catch her in the act.
Oh, darling.
Well, let's get out of here, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, Jeff.
You made it.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Oh, thanks. Come on, get pumpkin.
What was the delay?
Oh, don't ask. It's a good color. Well, what do you think?
Well, it's terrific, but it's a bit big, isn't it?
Oh, we had to get something big enough for the three of us. The first month, anyway.
Honey, are you sure this is a good idea?
What do you mean by that?
Well, it's bad enough Jeff having to get his mother-in-law from the jail, but spending his honeymoon with her, God.
Mum, Jeff's all right.
Yeah, I know, but he did disappear as soon as he dropped us off at the door.
Well, he had some business to attend to.
What sort of business, love? You're on your honeymoon.
Look, I told you about his uncle who trains trotters, didn't I?
Yeah.
Harness horses, you Yanks will call him, he said. Well, his Pride and Joy's racing tomorrow, and we're going to go and see it run.
Oh, honey, I can't. I'm starting work.
Only in the morning. I checked with your boss. Look, we'll have plenty of time to get there, and Jeff's uncle said it's got a really good chance.
You got it all worked out, haven't you?
I certainly have. Races tomorrow, and dinner tonight at the best restaurant in town.
Oh, look, I can't go to that. You and Jeff need to spend some time on your own.
We're not going without you.
Well, you'll have to, won't you? I mean... Well, I just got out of prison, for crying out loud. I'm not used to being in public. I mean, I wouldn't even know what to choose on the menu.
I'll choose for you.
Oh, I used the wrong fork and everything.
We won't be happy without you. Oh, go on, it was Jeff's idea.
Honest.
Honest.
All right. But if I eat my peas off my knife, it's not my fault.
You won't.
If we're going poshing around, I suppose I better try and do something with this. I got it for your wedding.
Wow. That's really nice, isn't it?
It's really awful, isn't it? Yes. I wish I could exchange it.
Really? Well, come on. What are we waiting for? Get your bag. All right.
Hi. Kate told me they let you out of hospital. Well, don't sound so pleased about it.
What's there to be pleased about?
Yeah, we're really a pair of old crocs, aren't we? Hey, I wonder what Jude's doing at the moment. Do you know my daughter came down from Queensland to visit her? Listen, if you keep this up, I'll break the other arm for you.
What have I done?
Nothing. That's the whole point. The least you could do if your mates are worried about you is tell them what's wrong.
Well, you know what's wrong? I got beat up.
There was a Barnhurst.
Yeah, it won't be any different here.
Doreen, what have you been up to?
I lagged.
On who?
Janie. Well, her and her mates used to come round after every bite and take everything I had. Got sick of it, I stood up to them and they bashed me, so I lagged.
You bloody fool.
Well, what else was I supposed to do? I was on my own. Judy had gone, nobody to help me.
Yeah, but no matter what happens, you don't lag.
I know that now. As soon as Janie was in solitary, her mates did this to me. They would have killed me if Vinegar hadn't transferred me back here.
Oh, yeah, your death wouldn't look too good on Vera's record.
Well, it's going to be on Davidson's record now, because the women are going to do the same thing to me here as soon as they find out.
Well, they haven't found out yet. There's a chance they won't. In the state I'm in at the moment, I'm not going to be much good to you. So you had better hope they don't.
Don't have many staff here, do they?
Look at this. Look at all this stuff at the back.
Do you like it?
Yeah.
There's someone now. Come on.
Oh, not her, love. She's the one that waited on me the first time.
Well, then she'll know exactly why you want to change it, won't she? Excuse me.
Yes?
My mother bought this dress and hat here last week and we'd like to exchange them.
Oh. You did choose this dress yourself, madam.
Oh, yeah, I know, but it was sort of...
Well, now she's changed her mind.
Oh, well, it was a week ago. We can't exchange it if it's been worn. I suppose you still have the docket?
Yes, I do.
What? Well, we don't give cash refunds.
We don't want a cash refund. All we want to do is exchange them. Look, Mum, you liked that, didn't you?
Yeah.
Well, do you want to try it?
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Certainly
it's a
is.
Good color.
That, madam, is a $135 outfit.
We didn't ask how much it was. We just want to try it, please.
Very well. I'll just process your refund first.
Look, I can't afford $135.
Don't worry, I'll pay the balance. It'd be worth it just to see the look on that bag's face.
Well, what do you think?
Oh, Mum, it's wonderful. It was made for you.
It's very comfortable, yeah?
Oh, good. I suppose it's not bad for off the peg. There you are. We'll have to hurry if we're going to get to the hairdressers. Otherwise, we'll never make it to Maxim's on time for dinner. I wonder, would you mind wrapping it for us while we're gone and we'll come and collect it later?
Yes, madam.
Thank you. Go on, Mum, change. I'll wait for you here.
All right, love.
Oh, Jim, God, you're still here. I thought I might have missed you.
Well, is there a problem?
No problem. I just thought if you'd wait till I finish my shift, then we could talk.
There's nothing to talk about.
Jim.
Look, it's been a long day. I'm tired and I'm going home, all right? Maybe some other time.
Jim! How dare you walk away from me in front of that bitch in reception?
I wouldn't have to walk away from you. Didn't chase after me.
I want to talk to you.
Nothing to talk about.
Well, I'll come round to your place tonight.
Don't bother, I won't be there.
You've got to come home sooner
don't
or later.
Bet on it.
Well, don't go to Meg's because that will be the first place I'll look.
Look, there's nobody around at the moment, so I may as well tell you. It's over between us, got it? So get lost.
Hang on. Oh, come on. There you go.
Oh, God. Home sweet home, eh?
Absolutely.
Didn't know we had two fridges.
What? How about another drink now?
Oh, are you kidding? I couldn't touch another drop.
Really?
Come on, I hope Jeff will be all right parking the car in that garage.
Of course he will be. He's hardly had anything to drink. Drinking mineral water most of the time.
Has he? I didn't notice, did I?
Not surprised to hear that. The way you and that waiter were eyeing each other off, it was dreadful.
Oh, come on, love. It's a bit late in the game for me to be changing my interests. Jeff, still worries about that, doesn't he?
Oh, no. Look, he's getting used to it, Mum. And he really likes you. In fact, he was saying to Mrs. Morris this afternoon, you were just like one of the boys.
After I spent all that money on this frock.
Oh.
Hey, I really had a nice time tonight. Thanks.
Oh, Mum.
It's a pity you have to go back to Queensland.
Yeah, I know. But if we didn't go back, my foster parents would be really upset, and you know that. And Jeff's got his job up there, too. You know I owe them a lot, don't you? Even if they have been so narrow-minded about you.
Sweetheart, I understand all that. You don't ever have to worry about that. What you do have to worry about now is Jeff.
Yes.
And what I have to worry about is my job tomorrow. I don't want to be late on the first day.
You won't be.
Good night, my sweet.
Good night. Mwah.
Just, this is all pretty fantastic, you know. I can't believe it. There I was this morning in that place, and now I'm here with you. You've given me something I'll never forget, Laurie. I love you.
Mum.
Sweetheart.